repeat with me the Pledge of Allegiance. In the absence of clergy, may we please bow our heads in a moment of silence. Reading of the Journal.
In Senate Tuesday, April 16th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The Journal of Monday, April 15th was read and approved. On motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the Journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state officers. Motions and resolutions. Senator Fischillo.
Senator Valesky.
Senator Valesky.
Senator Fischillo, thank you, Mr. President. I move that the following bills be discharged from their respective committees and be recommitted with instructions to strike the enacting clause. Senate Bill Numbers 1208A, 1211, 3043, and 3842.
So ordered. Senator Fischillo.
Mr. President, may we please adopt the resolution calendar with the exception of resolutions 1185, 1261, and 1262.
All in favor of adopting the resolution calendar with exception of resolutions 1185, 1261, 1262, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution calendar is adopted. Senator Fischillo.
Mr. President, there's a resolution at the desk by Senator Parker, 1185. I ask that the title be read and ask for its immediate adoption.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution Number 1185 by Senator Parker, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim April 2nd, 2013 as Autism Awareness Day in the state of New York.
Senator Rivera.
Mr. President, as I have stood on this floor many times, I am glad to do so today to speak just a little bit about autism and the impact that it can have on families and certainly the impact that it's had on mine. My older brother, Jose Manuel Rivera, Papotin, as we call him affectionately, who turns 44 years old this year, was diagnosed with autism very early on in his life, which changed my parents' life forever. And it definitely changed mine as well. It taught me a level of patience that many times has been tested. But overall, what the experience with my brother has demonstrated is that when these folks are given the opportunity, when they are provided with access to services so that their needs can be met, when they are surrounded by family members who are patient and loving, they can be successful individuals. Excuse me. And so today, as I stand to just once again say that anytime that we can bring attention to this issue, anytime that we can talk about those members of our families and our communities which are impacted by this, it is to remind ourselves that we are not talking about folks that can't be productive members of our society, but the total opposite is true. They are absolutely productive members of our society. My brother, as I've mentioned many times, has his job right now is to translate books into Braille down in Puerto Rico where he lives with my family. And I am proud of him every single day. And I know that there's many members of our body who have family members or friends who they are also proud of. So I stand to say to my colleagues that this is exactly the type of resolution that we should adopt, since it is a way to bring ourselves a little bit of more attention to this issue as it is necessary. To make sure that we know that these folks are part of our families, part of our communities, and should be valued. So thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Rivera. Are there other senators wishing to be heard on the resolution? Seeing none, the question is on the resolution. All in favor, signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Fischillo.
President, we'd like to open that up for co-sponsorship by other members.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Senator Fischillo.
There's a resolution at the desk by Senator Addabbo, 1261. I ask that the title be read and ask for its immediate adoption.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution Number 1262 by Senator Dabo, mourning the death of legendary Archbishop Molloy High School coach Jack Curran.
Senator Dabo.
Thank you, Mr. President. By the time I got to Archbishop Molloy High School in 1978, Coach Jack Curran was already a local legend. Over the last 50 years of coaching at Archbishop Molloy High School, Jack Curran won 5 New York City championships in basketball and 17 New York City championships in baseball. No other New York City coach won a title in both sports in the same year, yet Jack did it 4 times in 3 different decades. He's also the only high school coach in the New York State Hall of Fame for both basketball and baseball. He's the only high school coach to be elected to the as National Coach of the Year in both baseball and basketball. And with 2,680 victories combined for baseball and basketball, he's the most winningest coach in the country, high school coach. And even when I saw Jack last, as he was battling both lung and kidney illnesses, he was still advocating for better ball fields in our local parks and protecting athletic programs throughout the state. Jack passed away this past March 14th at the age of 82 in Rye, New York, where he lived. And he leaves behind an infinite impression of dedication, perseverance, and the will to live a successful life. And he will be missed. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Dabo. Senator Latimer, on the resolution.
My friend Senator Dabo pointed out the outstanding contributions that Jack Curran made as a coach. I knew Jack Curran as a person who lived across town from me, and I never really understood what an outstanding record he had until I read about him in the newspaper, because to see him back home at the local deli, at the bank, if you bumped into him at the hardware store, you saw a man who didn't carry his resume with him around on his sleeve. He was very self-effacing, and then to read about the tremendous accomplishments of this man who was a neighbor was really unbelievable and outstanding. I'm very fortunate in the district that I represent that I might run into at the local grocery stores where I shop, Jonathan Lippman, Timothy Geithner, people who I see on television. It happens to be one of those types of areas in New York State. But I'd never met a more outstanding man who was more normal and self-effacing and a wonderful man than I met in Jack Curran. And we mourn his passage.
Thank you, Senator Latimer. Are there other senators wishing to be heard on the resolution? Seeing none, the question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. May we please pause for a moment of silence to remember the life of Jack Curran. Senator Fischillo.
Mr. President, there's a resolution at the desk by Senator Hassel Thompson, number 1262. I ask that the title be read and ask for its immediate adoption.
The Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution Number 1262 by Senator Hassel Thompson, honoring Brian Fisher upon the occasion of his retirement after 44 years of distinguished service to the state of New York.
The question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Fischillo.
Senator Hassel Thompson would like to open up the resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you do not wish to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Senator Fischillo.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There's no further business at the desk.
There being no further business, I move that we adjourn until Monday, April 22nd at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Monday, April 22nd at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.